I'll do that. I do apologize for keeping you waiting so long. It's just I became a little preoccupied with setting up the sampler display. My name is Lloyd. Pleasure to meet you. Welcome to Lloyd's Gentleman's Boutique. Have you wandered through the shop? Finding everything satisfactory. Wonderful. Well, would you like to sample some of our new colognes that we have to offer this week? So, is there anything in particular that you like? Like any different scents? Or anything in particular you're searching for? Few of these, actually almost all of these, are right up your alley. I think you'll enjoy them. The only one that you really won't enjoy would be this one here. So, we won't even worry about that one. But the rest I think you might like. Decide which one. Well, might as well go in order, right? So we'll start off with that. Declaration by Cartier. So what I'm going to do is I'll show you the product. Tell you a little bit of information about it, some of the accords and the notes of the cologne itself, and that will allow you to sample the cologne. I'm sorry? Oh no, I won't spray anything on you personally. I was about to say, we use these tiny test strips. It's just a piece of cardstock paper. And what I'll do is, I'll just spray the tip and allow you to, take in the aromas of the cologne and witness it yourself without you having to leave the shop here smelling of a million colognes. So let's just take take a look at the first one here. Now, this is a very elegant cologne. This is Declaration by Cartier. And it's an amber woody fragrance for men. If you're into outdoors or nature, this might be the type of cologne that you enjoy. So Declaration was first launched in 2018, I believe. Now the nose behind this fragrance is methyled laurent, and the top note is bitter orange. It has a real top note of citrus, like when you're peeling an orange and you get the spray of the orange. It has a little bit of that as the top note. And some of the middle notes are spices, cardamom, and cumin. So, there's really a lot different things that goes into these fragrances, and that's what really makes it so elegant. Some of the base notes, and this is where the amber woody fragrance comes in play, and not surprisingly, it goes really well with the citrus. You wouldn't think that it does, but it does. But the base notes are leather, cedar, benzoin. I think there's velvet. It starts with a T. Tulip blossom. And of course, amberwood. It's really quite woodsy or outdoorsy. It's really for a masculine outdoorsy man, but still with some elegance. Let's try. See if we can pick out some or most of the notes. It really has quite an elegant little top piece here. If you look closely, it's really elegant how they made this. So let's try it out. As I hold the bottle closely, I can actually smell it already without spraying it. No. You can smell the amber wood, as well as the citrus. It's a bit spicy as well. It almost smells like a spice cabinet or spice rack, you know, in your grandma's kitchen. Am I right? You smell it too? Good. I was hoping I wasn't the only one. It's quite a delicious smelling cologne. So that is the Declaration by Cartier. Now for the next one. This here is Xerius. This is by Givenchy. Right. Quite an elegant bottle. Simple, but still has a touch of class. I really like this frosted glass approach mixed with the clear glass. It's really quite elegant. Again, simple but elegant. And of course, you have the diamond style lid. Adds a bit of class to it as well. It takes a simple bottle and just a little touch of something like this. But anyway, a little bit about this fragrance. So it's an aromatic fougère fragrance for men. Xerius was first launched in 1986. So it's been around for a while. Top notes of this fragrance are a little different than the last one we took a look at, but it also has some similarities, and we'll go over that. You'll also smell it as well, but the top notes are actually lavender. So it's kind of a relaxing scent. The lavender helps with that. Also jasmine, lemon, violet, nutmeg, bergamot, lily of the valley, and rose. So it has a lot of floral scent. Balances out the notes that I'm about to tell you, and those notes are what I'm saying is similar to the last one, which is sandalwood, coriander, and cinnamon. Base notes are even darker. balsam fir, leather, amber, cedar, incense, and musk. So it has quite a well-balanced recipe, if you will. You have your lighter notes. Then when you get to the middle notes, it gets a little bit stronger. And then your bass notes are the darkest and strongest. Let's try a sample. Away. You can smell it. You can smell that it's strong, but not too strong. Definitely smell the floral arrangement that's in there, but I also can smell the balsam fir. That's really, really one scent that stands out. Almost smells like Christmas. I can smell the cedar in there too. Cedar and balsam fir, you know, almost similar. And you can tell the difference. Smell a hint of musk in there. Sandalwood. How about you? Precisely. It's a very good cologne. Not too strong, not too weak. It's quite elegant, very masculine. Enjoy is this one. Now, the bottle, you know, nothing to stare at. It's quite a simple bottle. You have a plastic cap, you know, simple shape, and a square. Quite a surprise. And this is Zeno by Davidoff. And this was first launched in 1988 as a classical male perfume. Uncompromisingly masculine. It's elegant. Or heart. surrounded by masculine components. It kind of starts off stingingly fresh with lavender, palisander, clary sage, and bergamot at the top. It tops it off with some bergamot. Now the heart is composed as an elegant floral bouquet. And it kind of has some similar to the Sirius. It has geranium, which is quite different. It has rose, like the other one, as well as lily of the valley. And I think they both have jasmine. Yes, I'm pretty sure they both have jasmine. But it's warm, and it has manly components, despite of the floral scents. And these warm and manly components really lock down the composition. Some of the base notes for this fragrance are patchouli, cedarwood, and sandalwood, along with a tender touch of vanilla. So let me take a sample of this. Don't think too hard about it, but try and see if you can pick out the scent of vanilla. Let's try. Ken King. It's real, real faint. Like if you take a half of a sniff, you can almost smell the vanilla. I definitely smell the floral bouquet, that's for sure. As well as the cedar and sandalwood. By you. Yeah. It's quite elegant. And it really does. It really does lock down the composition. The floral bouquet, the cedar, the patchouli, sandalwood. Really goes good together. It's like a basket of almost like an autumn flower basket. You know how they, have the dried flowers, and they have like cinnamon sticks and some other woody type elements, like maybe some birch sticks or pine cones, you know, that type of thing. It's quite good. It's a very good fragrance. Now the next one would be this one here. Now, first, I want you to take a look at this bottle. Now, is that not an elegant bottle? You have this this real industrial type knob, and then we have a lion's head engraved in the back. You see here. Really quite elegant, really masculine looking. It almost almost throws off the vibes of power and success, you know, especially with the lion's head mixed with the industrial knob. It's a very nice box. Now, this bottle of cologne is by Lalacue Pour Homme, and it's a woody aromatic fragrance. It was first launched in 1997, so this is a little bit newer than some of the other ones that we've tested already. And the nose behind this fragrance is Maurice Rochelle. And it has top notes of lavender, rosemary, grapefruit. That's a new scent we haven't witnessed yet. It's grapefruit. Bergamot. Pomelo. Mandarin orange. And tangerine, I believe. Now, again, like some of the others, the middle notes get a little more deeper and darker, with notes of cedar, iris, which is a new scent for us, lily of the valley, and jasmine, with base notes of oak moss, sandalwood, vanilla again, patchouli, and amber. As you can tell, some of the notes are reoccurring with a lot of these fragrances, but that's the thing, is these reoccurring notes are really what makes a lot of these fragrances quite masculine. You know, some dark, outdoorsy, woodsy notes. Quite excited to test this one out. So let's open it up and see what it smells like. See if it adds up to the masculinity of the bottle. you can tell already. Unlike the other one we were trying to... There was the Davidoff that we were in search of the vanilla for. With this one, you don't have to go searching for the vanilla. It's quite strong. You can smell the vanilla that very first spray. Wow. I smell the cedar as well. Lavender. The lavender, the cedar, and the vanilla are really what's standing out to me. How about you? Can you smell anything different than what I'm smelling? Ah, yes, the sandalwood too. But see, I really don't smell that much. I smell more of the cedar and lavender and vanilla. Well, it really goes well together. It's quite a delicious aroma. Alright. Let's try one more. Do you have time for one more? This one here. Quite a modern but elegant bottle. This one's simple. It's just a square, but it has this glass bottle with a metal frame. So it's kind of got a modern executive style to it. And this is Euphoria by Calvin Klein. And it's a woody aromatic fragrance. It was first launched in 2006, I believe. 2005 or 2006. But the nose behind this fragrance is by a man named Carlos Benaim, I believe. As well as two other people, I think. I'm trying to think of their names. Lock Dong and Jean-Marc Chalin. Chalin, I think. Something like that. But back to the fragrance itself. The top notes are quite different than the other fragrances we tried. But then again, so are the middle notes and the base notes. I think there's only like three notes that are similar to the ones we've already tried. But the top notes of this fragrance are ginger and pepper. Right. What an interesting combination. Ginger. the pepper. The pepper's what worries me. Because sometimes, the pepper can make you, sneeze a lot. So, we'll see how that goes. But, the middle notes of this fragrance are black basil, sage, and cedar. With base notes of amber, suede, Brazilian redwood, and patchouli. So, with this fragrance, we get a few new aromas. Let's try it out. It's not really that strong, as you can kind of smell right now. It's really mild, but I do smell the Brazilian redwood, the cedar, and surprisingly, I smell the pepper as well. Now that's interesting. Try it out. Do you smell the pepper as well? Yeah, and just a tiny hint of it. It's really interesting, isn't it? Well, this is actually quite a very power aroma or fragrance. I can see, getting all suited up, going into a board meeting with this fragrance. It would definitely show power and success. I really enjoy that cologne. How about you? Could you see yourself wearing this cologne? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wouldn't say, all the time. Like going to a grocery store or something like that. But, big celebrations or business meetings, or maybe even a job interview, kind of show, your confidence and successful at what you do. Yeah, that'd be a perfect cologne for that. It's quite delicious. Well, I hope you enjoyed these colognes, and I hope maybe I could have persuaded you to purchase one of these very elegant and masculine colognes. If you have any questions regarding any of the colognes, I'd be happy to answer them. regarding these clones or any of our other clones that we have here at Lloyd's Gentleman's Boutique. I'll be back here, so feel free to come and ask. Alright? Great. Well, you will have yourself a wonderful day. The sun's out here in Lloydville. Also, let me recommend some things. Is this your first time in Lloydville? No? Okay. Well, if you haven't already gone to Lloyd's Watch Shop, there's plenty of watches there to complement some of these powerful colognes, as well as Lloyd's Gentleman's Suit Shop. Some very nice suits there. Yeah, check some of the shops out here on Main Street. You won't be disappointed. Alright, well, I won't take up any more of your time. It's been nice meeting you, and I'm happy I could share these colognes with you. And like I said, I hope you have a very nice day. Thank you.